Hi, y'all. This is To Whom It Concerns. Cease taking certain people at face value. You need to observe them at length, long term, to come to comprehension about what kind of fruits they really are packaged with. There's a scripture in the Bible that says, ye shall know them by their fruits in Matthew 7:16. And so you have to become a fruit inspector. Yep, don those gloves and those caps and get about inspecting those fruits, because you're being too trusting of certain people and their fruit is not lining up with their words and their expressions. So don't get caught up in the expressions and the physical looks, but focus more on how they're behaving on the regular and get to know who they are authentically. And you can save yourself a lot of stress if you do that. Now, I do want to mention this as well. There are Christian folks who are ruthless, devious, and deceptive, and they will quote you a string of scriptures in a New York minute, and you don't see conduct that lines up with that Bible that they quote so very well. And I'm not stereotyping, because there are some Christians, in fact I know a few of them, who are those I disagree with their spiritual beliefs, but I have appreciation because they are sincere about their spiritual postures, and they conduct themselves with love, kindness, and they share and they care, and they're honest people. So I'm not talking about all Christians. Notice that I said there are some Christians. I have met some who are ruthless, devious, and deceptive consistently. So I know what I'm talking about. And it's not just Christians I'm talking about in particular, but I've spent a lot of time around them because I was one of them for many years. So I know a lot about how the drill operates, the machine, so to speak. So all I'm saying to you is stop taking certain people at face value. You can love them, but some folks, you just have to give them a side eye until you see what kind of fruits they are growing and displaying habitually as a practice and as a lifestyle, because we all get off course sometimes on occasions. However, if people are off course more than they're on course, I would advise you do some reevaluating relative to your engagement with them and how often it should be. Now, of course, in a workplace, you don't have much options. You have to engage with folks that are just woo, challenging. However, there are ways to cope with them as well. And I also want to mention that people who are low frequency, as I said in the previous video, some of them just don't know any better. They are being their authentic selves. They are in those places because that's pretty much their frame of reference. And so we just have to have more tolerance and patience for people in that regard, because some of us were in similar straits at points in our lives. But again, the balances must be struck, because we don't want to be prey for predators because we're being too liberal with folks. So it's just a matter of how to navigate relationships. And I do want to caution not to be doing a whole lot of mean mugging on folks. It's called for to get firm, and sometimes you have to be fiercely demonstrative about your posture so people won't think they can run roughshod over you and your emotions and things like that. But I think some people go to an extreme with mean mugging and being belligerent and lashing out angrily. There are places for that, but I think some people do overtime in those zones, and that's just not wise or beneficial. We have to be more forgiving sometimes in our engagements with folks. And I also wanted to say this about some people that I'm dealing with currently. I don't trust them at all. However, I can laugh with them. I can say kind words to them. I can engage with them expressively and be cordial, laugh and joke and play. But I still don't trust them at all. That's the way it is. And unless they prove trustworthy, that's the way it's going to stay. Self-preservation is essential. But I don't need to be all up in their faces, gritting on them, explosively hurling insults at them and lashing out at them angrily. I can maintain my cool. Like I say, smile and laugh and chit-chat, small talk, and some more stuff. But what I don't do is trust them one damn iota. There's an art to relationships, people. And as we continue to mature, we learn the art of relationship engagements and how to best handle them. So, thank you. Bye now.